Here's a morbid thought to ponder. You are covered with dead skin cells. It doesn't matter if you are merely an infant, an adolescent, or someone in their prime or in their senior years. You might have a smooth, glowing skin like that of commercial models or celebrities, or it could be cracked and dry. Whichever it may be, one thing that is certain is that those dead skin cells will always be a part of your reality for as long as you live. While this may sound unnerving, to say the least, it's perfectly fine. In fact, you should be thankful for having dead skin cells. Why is that so? We have a simple explanation, as usual. But before we continue, please don't forget to like this video and to make sure you are subscribed to our channel. It will inspire us further to create more informative videos just for you. Basically, our skin is our first line of defense against harmful bacteria and chemicals, as well as the negative effects of the sun and temperature. The skin is also where vitamin D is produced by the body using sunlight as its main ingredient. The skin is made up of three layers. The topmost part, the one we see with our naked eyes, is the epidermis. It's a tough barrier against the outside world. It also regulates how much water our body loses. Immediately below the epidermis is the dermis, where the sweat glands, oil or sebaceous glands, nerve endings, blood vessels, and hair roots can be found. It helps in keeping our body temperature at normal levels and in the removal of waste products. The sebaceous glands also help keep our skin soft and smooth. Below the dermis is the hypodermis or subcutaneous tissue, which keeps the dermis attached to our muscles and bones. It is also where fat is stored. So why do we say having dead skin cells is ideal? It's because that is how we know our skin, which is the largest organ in our body, is functioning the way it's supposed to. The skin needs to refresh itself every day to function at its optimum. It does this by creating new skin cells in between the dermis and the epidermis. These cells are made up of proteins called keratin and collagen. They are pushed up as new cells are produced below them, essentially flattening them out and making them tougher. They also die in their journey towards the epidermis, where they perform their duty of protecting the skin in a similar fashion as the shingles on the roof of a house. Normally, there will be 20 layers of dead skin cells on the epidermis. But since the skin continuously produces new skin cells, the outermost dead skin cells would have to go. This means discarding about 30,000 of them on a daily basis. The dead skin cells flake off and turn into dust. In a year, you would be producing about 3.6 kilograms of skin cell dust. This would explain why your house remains dusty, even if you clean it every day. And that is why we have dead skin cells on our body. You may be wondering, if our skin cells are replaced regularly, how come tattoos and scars remain on our skin? Our skin is mainly made up of collagen, a protein produced by fibroblast cells. When we get wounded, the fibroblasts produce scar collagen, which is different from the skin's normal collagen. This remains in the skin and is not discarded. As for tattoos, they stay on the skin because the ink used has molecules that are simply too big for the white blood cells to ingest and carry away. Lasers that effectively remove tattoos do their job because they break down the ink particles into microfine dust that the white blood cells have no trouble handling. We hope you have enjoyed this latest episode of AHA, So That's Why. Please like it and let us know what you think in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.